In 1495, while on one of his voyages to the New World, Christopher Columbus encountered what would become the first tropical cyclone on record. He later declared that nothing but the service of God and the extension of the monarchy would convince him to expose himself to such danger again. Since that time, American coastal communities have faced the destructive power of tropical cyclones time and again. Here along the northwestern Gulf Coast, tragedy and loss as a result of hurricanes are all too familiar. But with each passing storm, the resiliency of our local communities become more apparent as towns and cities rebuild, often stronger and more prepared than they were before. And while many would rather forget the storms that upended their lives and devastated regions, by looking back on the events of the past, we can better prepare ourselves for the events of the future. Prior to the launch of Taros 1, the first successful orbital weather satellite in 1960, hurricane tracking relied almost exclusively on observations from traveling ships and offshore platforms. But given their relatively few ships traversing the vast expanses of ocean and their tendency to avoid rough weather, valuable observations were rare. On the evening of June 24, 1957, a shrimp boat in the Bay of Campeche reported sustained winds of 45 miles per hour in association with an area of low pressure in the southern Gulf. 3 days later, during the early morning hours of June 27, a Category 4 hurricane named Audrey roared ashore with maximum sustained winds of 145 miles per hour. Just about everyone who lives in or grew up across southern Louisiana and southeast Texas knows the story of Hurricane Audrey. This large storm with a 40-mile wide diameter eye spread a massive storm surge of 8 to 12 feet and weighs as high as 20 feet across most of Cameron Parish, as well as the southern halves of Vermilion, Iberia, and St. Mary parishes. In total, 1.6 million acres of land were flooded by Audrey's storm surge. The death toll from Hurricane Audrey has been estimated to be in excess of 500, although the exact number will never be known, as many who perished in the storm surge across Cameron and Vermilion parishes were swept out at sea. Audrey ranks as the seventh deadliest hurricane to ever strike the United States and the second deadliest in Louisiana behind Hurricane Katrina. Audrey is also remembered as the strongest hurricane to make landfall within the United States in the month of June. As terrible as Audrey was, the Northwest Gulf went 48 years without another major hurricane landfall. During that time, advances in satellite and radar technology allowed for great improvements in the forecasting and tracking of tropical cyclones. But it was only a matter of time before another major hurricane threatened the Northwest Gulf Coast. On September 7th of 2005, a tropical wave emerged off the west coast of Africa. On September 18th, the system was declared a tropical storm and given the name Rita. Over the next 36 hours, Rita would intensify rapidly from a tropical storm into the most intense tropical cyclone ever observed in the Gulf of Mexico. At its peak, Rita's winds were sustained at 180 miles per hour, making it a Category 5 hurricane on the Saffir-Simpson scale. With images of the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina still dominating news outlets, emergency managers across coastal Texas and Louisiana took no chances, ordering the largest evacuation in United States history. An estimated 3.7 million people fled the upper Texas and Louisiana coast prior to Rita's landfall. With so many attempting to flee, freeways and other main arteries were soon at a standstill. The combination of severe gridlock and an ongoing heat wave led to over 50 evacuation-related fatalities before the storm even arrived. Rita made landfall near the Texas-Louisiana border at 2:38 a.m. on the morning of September 24, 2005 as a Category 3 hurricane. Maximum sustained winds at landfall were observed to be 120 miles per hour. These winds pushed a storm surge of 10 to 15 feet into much of southwest Louisiana and 5 to 10 feet across southeast Texas. Nearly every structure across southern Cameron Parish was completely destroyed. In addition, Rita spawned 90 tornadoes as it came ashore, one of which resulted in a death. Total damage as a result of Hurricane Rita has been estimated to be in excess of $12 billion. Although any loss of life is tragic, the seven deaths directly attributed to Rita stand in stark contrast to the hundreds of lives lost due to Hurricane Audrey. Clearly, the improvements made to emergency preparedness and hurricane forecasting have made a valuable difference in the ongoing effort to save lives from the destructive power of hurricanes. Nearly five decades have passed between Hurricanes Audrey and Rita, but the area had only three short years to prepare for the next major impact. After wrecking havoc on Hispaniola and Cuba earlier in the week, Hurricane Ike barreled ashore near Galveston, Texas on the morning of September 13, 2008, with maximum sustained winds near 110 miles per hour. Ike was noted for his unusually large size. At its largest, Ike measured over 600 miles in diameter, with hurricane force winds extending nearly 200 miles from the center. The combination of Ike's large wind swat and the fact that the wind swat piled water over the shallowest portion of the Gulf led to much higher than normal storm surge flooding along the upper Texas and Louisiana coast, with a storm surge reaching north of I-10 in some locations. With the exception of Port Arthur, who was spared thanks to its seawall, the entire southern half of Jefferson County was inundated with an 18 to 19 foot storm surge experienced to the south and east of High Island. Across southwest Louisiana, storm surge values of 10 to 14 feet were common. Ike was directly responsible for the deaths of 20 people across Texas, Louisiana, and Arkansas, and caused nearly $30 billion of damage, making it the third most costliest United States hurricane, only behind Hurricane Katrina and Sandy. We've come a long way from the days when Christopher Columbus first encountered nature's most powerful storm. And as technology continues to improve and hurricanes become better understood, warnings will become more accurate, hopefully leading to fewer fatalities. But with more people living in coastal locations now than ever before, the risk associated with hurricanes have never been higher. That's why it's important to prepare yourself now so that you can be ready when the next storm threatens. For more information on how to better prepare yourself and your family for hurricanes and other emergencies, please visit www.getagameplan.org. And for the latest hurricane information, visit www.hurricanes.gov.